welcome to Not Your Grandma's Opera. So today we're going to start a new series. It's going to be all about opera composers. And I'm just going to kind of talk about the main opera composers. And today we're starting with Mozart. So I am going to admit quite a bit out of Mozart's story. That's because he just wrote so many things. And since this is an opera channel, we're going to stick with all his opera kind of stuff. Everyone's heard of Mozart. Everybody loves Mozart, right? He's one of my favorites, actually. It's just his music just makes me feel good. And of course, everyone has also seen the movie Amadeus. It's actually a fabulous movie and a fabulous play, completely inaccurate, but I'd still recommend going to see or seeing it, not going to see it. It's from the 80s, but definitely seeing it because it's a great movie. Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. So here's some facts about him. He was born on January 27th, 1756. And he died December 5th, 1791. He was born in Salzburg, which is modern day Austria. Back then they called it the Holy Roman Empire. Now he's known for composing more than 600 works, and we're talking operas, concertos, sonatas, you know, you get everything with that. So he was also a musical prodigy, and he wrote his first composition. He was either 4 or 5. Historians debate that a little bit. They're not entirely sure. His first opera was Idomeneo, and it premiered in January of 1781 in Munich. Of 1781, Mozart first went to Vienna. Now he has been traveling a lot, but this is really the first time that he goes to Vienna and decides that he wants to stay in Vienna. His first opera in Vienna was actually Abduction from the Seraglio, and it premiered on July 16th, 1782. At that same time, he was also married in August of 1782 to Constanza, and they had 6 children, but only 2 survived into adulthood. Now, while this is going on, he's kind of fighting with like this archbishop who wants him to stay in Salzburg, but he's dying to go to Vienna. And he goes to Vienna as part of the archbishop's entourage, actually. And while in the entourage, he gets to meet the emperor, and he convinces the emperor to let him stay. His next opera was written in 1786. Mozart actually took about 4 years off from composing opera, and he was just kind of composing all these other things. And being a concert musician, he was very popular in the concert scene in Vienna at the time. But his next opera was written in 1786, and it was Marriage of Figaro, which is actually one of my, probably my favorite Mozart opera. I just absolutely love Figaro. It's one of my favorites. I named my cat after it. That's how much I love that opera. In 1787, he wrote Don Giovanni. Also in 1787, Emperor Joseph II appointed him as chamber composer. So now he kind of permanently cemented his place in Vienna. But at that same time, his chamber composer life is starting to go down. And that's because there's the Austro-Turkish War. Because of this war, concerts are actually starting to not be performed as much. So now Mozart isn't performing as much as he would like. In 1790, Così fan tutte premiered. The last opera was La Clemenza di Tito, and the premiere in Prague. That's where he first started to get sick. In 1791, he continued to work though, and he conducted the premiere of The Magic Flute on September 30th, 1791. But after that, his health started to really rapidly decrease, especially after November 20th, where he had a fall. He was still mentally occupied with finishing his Requiem. And then he died on December 5th, 1791 at age 35. A lot of this is covered in the movie, but there was, well, Salieri did exist, but he did not try to kill Mozart. It was not foul play. A lot of historians disagree what killed Mozart. Most of the consensus is syphilis. Other people say it was some kind of fever or flu, but most syphilis. So that's kind of Mozart's story. Now, those are all his operas. We have got Idomeneo first, and then Abduction from the Seraglio, then Figaro, Don Giovanni, Così fan tutte, so Clemenza di Tito, and Flute. So those are his only operas. You've heard these operas, even if you don't know that you've heard them. because they're everywhere. They're so familiar. It's on commercials, it's in movies, it's everywhere. I wrote 6 of them, but they're all absolutely fabulous and they're still in common rep today. He is one of my favorite composers. I love all his works, even his piano sonatas, his symphonies, everything. I absolutely love his stuff. But that's really kind of his story, his basic opera story. Of course, there's a lot more, but we're gonna focus a little, we focused on his opera story, not his whole life story, or else we'd be here for a very, very long time. And I'd just be giving you all these dates and details because I'm into history and I'm a nerd. So I hope you enjoyed this little bit of info on Mozart and his operas.